Recently, I've been trying to find the best upscaler for my workflow. Last week, I did a video on ScaleUp, a plugin for After Effects and Premiere Pro, and while it does a pretty good job, I wanted to compare it with some software that's been popping up on my recommended list. Welcome back to the channel, and today we're looking at Topaz Labs Video Enhance AI. This content is not sponsored, it's just to satisfy my curiosity, but if you're in the market for an upscaler, then stay tuned. While the software does perform well, it comes with some caveats. Alright, so let's jump into After Effects and take a look at how we can upscale this desert shot from 720 to 4K. I'm going to bypass simply scaling this up by 300% with bicubic sampling and move straight to the detail preserving upscale effect that comes with After Effects. Scaling from 720 to 4K results in a clear loss of detail in the sand ripples, the woman's hair, and the edges of the dress. Now, with ScaleUp, a plugin for After Effects, we get a notable improvement to the overall image. However, when we compare this with the original 4K plate, we can see that we lose detail in the shadows of the sand ripples, in the hair, and we've lost grain in the dress. Now, you can always add grain back in, but with After Effects grain, you'll see your render times increase dramatically. So here lies the problem with these techniques. If you're interested in a more in-depth comparison between bicubic sampling, the detail preserving upscale, and ScaleUp and what settings to use, check out the previous video. Now let's see how well Video Enhance AI handles the upscale. First of all, we need to import the plate. You can choose from some standard video and image formats. I'm using a TIFF sequence, and I'll explain why a bit later. After the plate loads in, there are only a few settings that you can actually change. So we want to set the output resolution to 4K UHD, then pick the AI model. There's also the ability to add grain back into the shot. So you might think, why would you want to add grain? But usually when you're doing upscaling, you're also doing a little bit of denoising as well, which removes grain. So in order to match the original plate, you often have to add grain back in. This is a feature that's lacking with the detail preserving upscale and is lacking in ScaleUp as well. But we'll just leave this on the default settings for now and then go down and click preview. This takes a moment depending on your system, but then you'll get a snippet of the original plate upscaled without any sampling on the left-hand side. And then on the right-hand side, you get the AI upscale. So we can pause the playback and take a look at the differences. So right away, we see that it's done a good job with the sand and the hair, but the dress looks very pixelated on certain frames. Plus, there's far too much grain. So let's back out and let's lower the grain amount and the size and switch the AI model from Artemis to Gaia. There's also an AI model picker, though I'm not really sure how helpful this is. There's also an option to switch between CG-generated video versus live-action video, and that's pretty good because CGI can often suffer from aliasing issues, and these methods help to alleviate it. I've tried out all the models, but Gaia seems to produce the most natural-looking results in my opinion. Artemis is good for accentuating details, but it can often add too much detail or detail that doesn't exist in the plate. With the new settings, we can preview it again, and I think the results are pretty good. When you're ready to render, you can change the output format, so I'm just using 8-bit TIFFs, and then change the output location. Then just click Start Processing. You can also batch multiple plates by importing more into the queue. So comparing Video Enhance AI's Gaia model upscale versus the original 4K plate, it looks very similar. And that's at 200%. At 100%, it looks even closer. So here's a comparison of the detail preserving upscale, ScaleUp, Video Enhance AI, and the original 4K plate. I've also included the render times for each method. You can judge for yourself, but besides the edges of the dress, which ScaleUp sharpens a bit better than the other methods, Video Enhance AI produces an image that is closer to the original. But, and it's a big but, Video Enhance AI doesn't take the source color space into account when outputting renders. So converting a file in a YUV color space to RGB color space results in a noticeable color shift. For example, if I take a ProRes file encoded with the Rec. 709 profile into Video Enhance AI, I output the images as a TIFF sequence, load the output back into After Effects, interpret that as Rec. 709, it produces this result. This, unfortunately, is unusable. The conversion from YUV to RGB should result in an almost indistinguishable difference in color if the source and output color space are taken into account. I did contact Topaz Lab support, and they confirmed that Video Enhance AI currently does not take into account the source color space or color profile. A solution is to render out TIFFs from After Effects for Video Enhance AI to use, and then everything is fine. You can also import an H.264 file and export it as an H.264 file, but this inevitably results in a loss of quality. If you're using Video Enhance AI for any type of production where you need to minimize quality loss, then you'll want to export TIFFs or PNGs. But here comes the other two major annoyances. First of all, there's no compression options available, so free up your hard drive because uncompressed TIFFs at 4K are rather large. And secondly, there's no option to rename the image sequences. All the files are just the frame number. I can batch rename these, but it baffles me why there's no option to set a file name prefix. Of course, I might be missing some hidden functionality, but the user guide doesn't mention it for image sequences. It's also irritating to have to re-preview the upscaled version every time you want to change a setting like grain. This might just be how the AI model works, but it's cumbersome nonetheless. So those are the bad things about the software. Fortunately, its ability to upscale is objectively better than the detail preserving upscale and ScaleUp 2 in many cases. I have a collection of various shots to illustrate the differences of the detail preserving upscale, ScaleUp, and Video Enhance AI. In order to keep the results as fair as possible, the source video files were first converted to uncompressed TIFF sequences. Although for After Effects, you would typically just upscale using the original file and bypass the TIFF conversion, even though that processing a TIFF sequence can be faster than a ProRes or H.264 file if you have a fast enough SSD. The detail preserving upscale, ScaleUp, and the original 4K versions were rendered from an 8 bits per channel workspace to uncompressed TIFFs to match Video Enhance AI as closely as possible. The original 4K plate was also converted to a TIFF sequence and re-rendered as a TIFF sequence to act as a control variable when testing render times. That said, these render times are really only useful when comparing the various upscale methods with the same shot. Everyone's setup is different, so definitely try out the software first if you're thinking of purchasing. A ScaleUp requires a GPU, and Video Enhance AI runs significantly faster on the GPU. Alright, let's take a look at this awesome shot of a manta ray. With Video Enhance AI, the particles in the water are clearer and the edges of the manta ray are closer to that of the original. With this next shot of a butterfly, ScaleUp and Video Enhance AI's Gaia model is very close. But here, I wanted to take a look at the Artemis model too. Even though that Gaia is closer to the original, Artemis accentuates the detail, and it does so in a pretty natural way, at least for this shot. I can see a use case for AI upscaling that provides more clarity to the original plate. I just wanted to show that result in the comparisons. This shot of coffee beans is pretty close on all the methods, but both ScaleUp and Video Enhance AI do produce a better overall image than the detail preserving upscale. To scrutinize the results, Video Enhance AI wins as there's more detail preserved in the center of the beans. Based on your workflow and the shots that you need to upscale, maybe weigh the price of ScaleUp and the ability to work directly in After Effects to the price of Video Enhance AI at its quirks. But overall, the quality of the final image is paramount. So far, we've only looked at organic subjects, but it's useful to look at hard surface objects too. A lot of the fine detail here is missing at 720, so the texture of the projector's surface is missing on all the models. But it looks closer to the original with Video Enhance AI's Gaia model, as does the volumetric light beam. Now, this shot of a car was the first one that I was honestly disappointed with ScaleUp's upscale. The blur and the distortion on the road in the foreground and the edges and the stripe on the car are far better with Video Enhance AI when compared with ScaleUp. Now, this shot is particularly interesting. While ScaleUp is very close to the original, it lacks detail in the water and the foam and overall is a bit too soft. However, this time with Video Enhance AI's Gaia model, it adds too much detail. Like with the Artemis model on the butterfly shot, there's far more definition on the rocks and there's some detail that isn't in the original 4K plate. However, I think it imagines the detail pretty well, but it's a bit too sharp for my liking. The Artemis model, though, is a bit too soft. Now, of course, in After Effects, you could blend the Gaia output versus the Artemis output with some simple opacity, but that does result in a lot more time spent on the upscale. Lastly, an important aspect of an upscaler is its ability to handle text. Now, this is personally what I'm trying to use upscaling for, because a lot of the tutorials that I want to record look too small at native 4K. But when I record at 2K and upscale that 4K, the UI is often a little bit too blurry, so I want to be able to sharpen that. Here, both ScaleUp and Video Enhance AI produce wobbly letters, but Video Enhance AI seems to add far more contrast and thickness around the edges and more distortion. I think ScaleUp wins in this comparison. All in all, despite the annoyances and the workflow required to prevent color shifting, Video Enhance AI does a very good job upscaling from a very low resolution. If you're only upscaling from 2K or maybe 1080, then ScaleUp is probably fine in many cases, and with a little love, The detailed preserving upscale with some slight sharpening can produce decent results as well. The advantages of ScaleUp is that you can work directly in After Effects or Premiere Pro, and the price is much cheaper than Video Enhance AI. However, if image quality is vital for your project, Video Enhance AI is certainly worth a try. As I said earlier, this is not sponsored, but check the description for a link to the trial. It's time limited, but otherwise fully functional without a watermark. And there are other upscalers too, so if you think I'm missing a good one, let me know in the comments. There's also an interesting video by MDMZ where he compares the results of Gigapixel AI, Sharpen AI, and Video Enhance AI. It's worth a watch if you're interested in upscaling. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this overview of Video Enhance AI and how it compares with the detail preserving upscale and ScaleUp. If you did, a like really helps out the channel. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment or reach out on the Discord server. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Peace.